The big story this morning, we're hearing from the family of a man who was hit and killed and left for dead on a Northwest Baltimore road Saturday night.
He's been identified as 62-year-old James Little Jr. Police say they have questioned a person of interest. 11 News reporter Rob Roblin is live at police headquarters with more details on the story. Good morning, Rob.
This terrible accident happened on Saturday night. James Little leaves behind three daughters and several grandchildren.
Love people, and he loved life. And he wanted to live life to fullness, and he wanted to make sure everybody was happy around him.
Teresa Little Lee remembers her big brother, James Little Jr., as the man who would give you the shirt off his back. She's still trying to come to terms with the fact that she'll never see him again. At 62 years old, James was hit and killed by a Jeep walking along Greenspring Avenue Saturday night. Police say the driver, a 20-year-old woman, kept going after she hit James.
Then to do is stop, and maybe she could have helped him at the time, but by her riding, maybe she could have put him in the Jeep and took her to the hospital herself to save his life.
But she didn't. Police say they caught up with the driver later and brought her in for questioning and a breathalyzer test, but released her. Teresa believes James was on his way to her house at the time of the accident. He was supposed to go to church with her Saturday night, but he never showed up. Instead, the police came to her home and told her what had happened.
I'ma really miss him because he always tried to support me as the youngest sister in anything, and he always congratulated me and always told me, you know, he was proud of me.
Teresa hopes the driver realizes the magnitude of what she's done in taking a life and taking James away from his family.
Our family do forgive her, but I just hope she give her life to Christ and ask God for forgiveness. Because that's what James would want her to do, ask God for forgiveness.
Now, police are awaiting the results of toxicology tests on the driver. This investigation continues. Reporting live, Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV, 11 News.